this back up so it's in live streaming mode. I think that's working. What I'll do now is see if I can get the live feed up from the camera. And we are live. Okay, so there we are. So now I've got the feed coming off the camera. I can actually take a green screen. So over here I have a square of green screen that I can place in front of the camera, and we can digitally replace everything from within that square. How's that looking? Ah, perfect. Okay. Now I just tell the camera there's the green screen. Okay. And I want to remove all of that. Ah, perfect. Okay, so now everything that's green gets replaced with the rest of the footage. But the rest of the footage contains the green screen, right? So can you see the next green screen down is also... You know what? Let's go down there and have a closer look. Right, so the next one down is also replaced with the rest of the footage. But it contains that... We can go a lot faster than this. Right, it contains the next one, which contains the next one. Right, this, it goes as fast as you want. I did put an emergency brake on it. And there. Okay, right, so ignore the fact the point of view is moving around the room, but the camera never moves. It's so good. Okay, so what we can do now is have a look in the other direction, because we're a long way down infinitely many of these realities. So if we grab this, swing it around, here's you all enjoying the show, and then what is that? What is that floating above you, right? That is what it looks like when you go back up.
Welcome to the Mass Gear office, where Helen, Steve, and I have signed hundreds of our new Festival of the Spoken Nerd DVD, You Can't Polish a Nerd. It's also available in less obsolete media. You can get it as a download, and more obsolete media. We've also released it on floppy disk. Not a joke, this has actually happened. So to celebrate the release of this, because it's literally out like right now when this video has gone online, I have some behind the scenes footage. So the show is, well, I do a lot of hilarious mathematical recursion, which is why the front cover has the spiral frame recursive effect on it. And I talk about the Droster effect. I've got everyone's favorite mathematical cocoa powder, the picture-in-a-picture recursion. And, oh, and actually, the limited edition cover, if you happen to order that, where literally you just get the cover. It's not that great, but it's got extra recursion because on the front of it, there's a picture of us holding the cover we're on, which is a reference to this textbook that the internet got very excited about a little while ago, where the people on the textbook are holding the textbook they're on the cover of. But I was sad to see when I actually bought a copy of this on the back, it's just one of the people from the front holding the same front of the textbook. So we thought we'd fix that. On the back of our limited edition cover, there's a picture of the back of us holding the back of the cover, because we think we're just that funny. So while I was on tour, I did a live version of this video you may have seen I did with Henry Segerman, where we took a spherical camera, a camera that can see in every direction at the same time, and we post-production to take the footage coming off this and do a recursive effect. In the show, we decided to do it live. So I worked with another programmer, a guy called Aaron Montag, and we got it happening live on stage. And when he came to see the show, because he lives in Germany, he flew over to Norwich, I was like, hey, let's have a chat about the maths. And so this is a video of when I had a chat to Aaron when we were on tour last year. So it's back when I had hair. It's very nostalgic. So this is the maths behind recursive spherical footage. What I'm doing today is we wanted to do this live on stage as part of the tour. And for that purpose, I had to get in a new mathematician programmer to give me a hand, which is the mysterious person you saw before. Aaron, great to see you. This is the system we've been using while I've been on tour.
Okay, so here we see ourselves.
From here.
From here.
Okay,
from
so this. Aaron's got his own spherical camera we've rigged up to his laptop, and there we are, there you go.
Yeah, so we are like here right on the sphere, and the content of the sphere is kind of projected back, so watch your nose.
There's my nose. Sorry, I moved. So there's one dot on my nose on the sphere, and then there's a dot down here on the infinite plane underneath.
So that means like in order to compute the color on this plane, please stand still.
I will move. Yep.
Yeah, we consider this ray and take the color from this intersection. So everything is copied down.
Right, and this is the stereographic projection of the sphere to the infinite plane beneath it. And you're taking the spherical footage from the camera and
from the camera,
smearing it out across the... Wow, that's really nice.
Yeah.
Right, okay, so now once you got on the plane, what are you going to do with it?
So actually the plane we consider...
Oh, there's the actual plane, yep.
We consider this plane as the complex numbers.
Right.
Field as the complex numbers, and now we can do like mathematics on this. So for example, we can...
Oh, so your current equation is just z equals z.
Z equals z.
Which is not very exciting.
Okay. That's not really exciting, but now I can have like some other equation like z plus 1. What does it mean?
Oh, moves it across. Okay.
We move it a little bit. It's actually like a little bit like this backward projection. So like at the point 0, we look up the function f and see what value does it compute. And it computes 1.
Right.
So 0 gets mapped to 1.
And 0 is now mapped to 3.
Yeah, and all these projections are mapping life.
Back onto the sphere.
The sphere.
Okay.
Actually, we want to create this spherical thruster effect.
Yep.
And how we can do this? So let's just watch this from the top. The idea is actually the following. We want to transfer this image in polar coordinates.
Right.
And then we cut out one slice, replicate the slice, and then...
Put it inside the polar coordinates again.
So, yeah.
Right, okay, alrighty, let's do it.
So let's just put it, transfer it in polar coordinates. This can be done by applying some analytic function, taking the logarithm.
Right.
So I just apply it.
So you're exponential because you did the reverse of the function.
Yeah, I have to reverse the function because it's... So now we have everything in polar coordinates.
It's just kind of, it's peeled it out.
Yes, yes. So here's like, here on this side we have 0, here we have like infinity, and here we have like the angle.
Got it.
And now we want to replicate one single strip.
Yep.
This we can do by taking the modulus function.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
And okay, now it's a little bit
Yeah. Oh, and you can shift it from before.
Yeah,
okay.
Shift it. Ah. And now we go back like to standard coordinates.
So you've unpeeled it.
Yeah.
Repeated it. Okay, and now you're going to curl it back around.
Yeah, now I'm going
to curl it. So you're going to undo the, you're going to log that,
So the reverse function. And here we are. Like inside.
Oh, so what went from being parallel copies became concentric copies?
Yes.
Right.
And everything is projected back like on the sphere. So I can also animate this. So let's just have some. I'm here. Seconds.
So you subtract the time in seconds. Oh, hey.
And yes.
And that's what I was doing on this.
Yeah, that's actually what we were doing live. So we can just try the same thing like with real footage. We first transfer this to polar coordinates by taking the logarithm of this image.
Yep, same as before.
So.
And so you keep mentioning complex plane because you're using the complex coordinates, I guess, for each position on the plane to do these mappings.
Yeah. Right. The nice thing is, like, if you have these analytic mappings on the complex plane, they have this property that they preserve, like, angles locally.
Right.
And then the stereographic projection itself also preserves the angles. So if we use these operations behind...
Yep, angles stay the same.
So
nice.
We have it now in polar coordinates. So, like, if I go around with my finger, it's moving to the top and top and top.
Oh, look at that. You're constantly going, like, my hand is just constantly rising in the image.
Yes.
That's amazing. Okay.
And now
we got to duplicate it.
Let's take this strip. Let me try this thing. Oh, that's maybe a little bit
too much.
Yeah, I have to shift it maybe like this. Yeah, that looks
that's
good.
That's about right. Yeah.
And now we have this shifted image. And now we take the exponential of this image and... Put it back onto the sphere. Standard. And maybe let's move this again.
So now there's basically a circular hole underneath the camera, which is then, that's the bit we're rising up and around. Oh, that's very nice. And that's just going to, you're using seconds again and zooming in. So I actually have, could you pass me the packet over there? This is my droster.
Yes.
So there's my packet of hot chocolate. And in this one, obviously, you're only replacing that particular spot there with the image. Here, you're cheating, but in a good way. You're just replacing a circle from underneath, which is, the, yeah. I guess, the easiest way. When I asked you nicely, you then had to do some, I mean, reasonably straightforward programming to then take this, make it actually a rectangle, make it green screen, and do all the rest of it. But it's this is the math that's happening behind.
Yeah, that's the math. Like everything else, what you if you wanna transfer like a rectangle, you only have to calculate some offset for the rectangle, and then you transfer like this. But it's the same mathematics.
Yes, that's the essence. Oh, that's so good. That one equation. That's my show. I do that equation live on stage. And if people want to have a play with this, we've actually got a version on the Festival Spoken Nerd website. We'll be linked straight to Aaron's website. I'll put a link to that in the description. You can either use your own webcam and do this, or the ridiculous green screen version, or if you do have a spherical camera, you can plug it in. And we'll put some links to this in the description if you want to check it out. It is phenomenal stuff. Now, there's one last part of the show that Aaron did the programming for, and it uses a spherical camera. But to show you how that works, I've been joined by a friend of mine, Ken. So Ken here and I have done math stuff together on and off throughout the years. And as you can see, he can juggle. So what we're going to do is pop the camera. Actually, Aaron, do you want to come over here as well and give me a hand with this? There we are. But I was going to try and whoop it.
Okay.
No.
Go for it.
Impeccable. Okay, right. So now you can see on the screen over here, we've got Ken juggling, and Aaron's written some more code so we can duplicate the Kens. So instead of just the one Ken from overhead, now we've got two. And what's really nice about this is if you look at the juggling tricks, each trick is between two versions of Ken. Right, and so it's a team effort. I like that. It's a good metaphor for performing. And there's now three. So wait, did you do this? Is this stereographic again, or
Yes, it's actually possible to do this via the stereographic projection.
Nice.
But
that's okay. You know, you carry on.
Describe this with complex analysis. What is done here? So the idea is again, you convert this image to polar coordinates.
Yep.
And then you multiply everything by three. So you have like each angle. You will see each angle three times.
Oh,
and
nice.
So you will also see three Kens.
Or we can have four Kens or five Kens. Let's go, actually, you know what, there's another one you've done, which will take me a second to load up. Here now, we've got a Ken inside a Ken. So we can actually start to zoom in, and you can see there's always another Ken further down, and we can have more Kens. There's pairs of Kens, and as a spiral. So how on earth did you do this?
Yeah, basically, it's actually the same thrust effect as we've seen before, only we have like a little bit twist and duplicate. So if you go back to the first one, it's like the thrust effect. Actually, it's the thrust effect with only some sphere cut out, and the other side we don't see.
And that's what we were pretty much doing before, just one little section of it.
Yeah. That's what we do. And now if you duplicate him.
Do you want to duplicate? There you go, duplicate. Yeah. So what's happening now?
So we took Ken's image in polar coordinates and scaled it down by factor two. So we see like two Kens.
Yep.
And if we put it back like the normal coordinates.
Double Ken. And again, on this one here, I can start to zoom. And then the spiral, there we are. One spiral.
So that's taking Ken in polar coordinates, rotate him.
Yep.
And push him back to a standards coordinate.
There you go. And what about the two spirals? Is that, I guess, you're duplicating that?
Yeah, it's, again, like some duplicating.
Good times. So if you want to order the DVD, either the physical DVD, digital download, or floppy disk, you can go to shop.festivalofthespokennerd.com. We really appreciate it. It's hugely useful, very supportive if people actually buy the show. We're very proud of it, and it would be nice. We've entirely funded this ourselves, so please, please buy it. If you happen to be one of my Patreon supporters, you will have already got a discount code which gives you £5 off. So if you support me on Patreon, you can get that discount. If you don't support me, you can sign up for less than £5, get the discount code, and then cancel. I'm not telling you what to do, just saying that's an option. And yeah, so there's loads of other bits and pieces that go with it. We made t-shirts, check it out. So do download it or buy it if you can. If not, there'll be loads more YouTube videos for you to enjoy for free. There you go. And so I'm going to end this one with the final word going to past Matt doing some hat juggling. Thanks so much for watching this video. I'm hugely indebted, of course, to my Spoken Nerd colleagues, Helen and Steve, for making this whole thing possible, and our tech guy, Matt Buckley, who came in to do all the lights and the tech side of this, and Trunkman Productions, who filmed and produced this video. Thanks for all the viewers who came along to the live shows to say hi. I really appreciate it. And of course, thanks so much to my Patreon supporters who make this kind of stuff possible. Because of your support, we're able to fly Aaron over from Germany. It's the first time I met him. Normally, we communicate via comments in code to actually have a closer look at the mass. I absolutely appreciate that. And of course, we've got Ken as well. You came in from, you cycled in?
From Norwich.
From Norwich. He cycled in from Norwich, which is not that impressive because we're in Norwich. So there you are. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. It's not bad.